Oh, nice overtake. DRS now enabled. DRS enabled. So the gap to the car ahead, 2.1 seconds. Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Green flag. tyre condition still looking good. Right, let's go, come on. Perfect job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Look after these tyres now, and we'll finish the race in this compound. Daniel's in the pits. The car behind you's just come in for the hard tyres. Car behind, running hard tyres. Okay, push, push. Gap to the car behind. 1.5 seconds. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 5.1 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Managing your tyres, manage your tyres. Final lap of the race. just 2 laps of fuel remaining now. Superb driving. That is the race win, my friend. Well done.
It's victory in Mexico, then. And what a victory it is after an incredible Grand Prix. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
I think the key here is just the quality of the racecraft, you know? I mean, how many overtakes did they make overall? I'm sure we have a stat person keeping score somewhere, and it was fantastic to watch, wasn't it? This is a strategic sport at the end of the day, but it's always really gratifying to see close-fought battles on track. It's what all the fans are after.
And it's time now for the podium celebrations. And how well-deserved is this one? This is a team all about giving talented young drivers an opportunity to race and to win. AlphaTauri are your winners here today. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Yuki Tsunoda gets my vote today.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. And it's another title in the bag for Red Bull after a long and hard-fought season. They've built an astonishing car this year, and the glory they'll be taking back to Milton Keynes is fully deserved. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.